वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ ओरिएंटल पब्लिक स्कूल। टुडे आई एम हेयर विद अ वीडियो ऑफ क्लास 9 पॉलिटिकल साइंस लेसन 2 एंड आवर टॉपिक इज डिस्टिंग्विशेस बिटवीन डेमोक्रेटिक एंड नॉन डेमोक्रेटिक फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। I mean to say, in today's class we are going to discuss about what are the basic differences between democratic and non-democratic form of government. As you can see on screen, democracy is the best form of government as the rulers are accountable to the people and have to fulfill their needs. We can say that in democracy, people elect the rulers and rulers rule the country as per the requirement and wishes of the common people, and this is the very countable form of government. And now moving to the next opposite side, to the non-democratic government, the rulers are not accountable to the people and their needs. While we are talking about non-democratic form of government, in non-democratic form of government, people are not accountable to the people and their needs. Even in this form of government, people don't have any right to elect the government, means we cannot elect even the government. Next point, to the democratic side, in democratic government, people elect their rulers and have right in decision making. I mean to say, in democracy, people have right in electing the government as well as taking decision if there is required. But in non-democracy, people don't elect their rulers and have no right in decision making, you are nowhere involved in decision making. All the authority regarding decision making or decision taking is totally given to the rulers. There is no any talk about the common people. So once again, moving to the democratic side, the parliament is a separate body and has no interference of army. In democratic country, parliament is the separate body where army cannot intervene or interfere in its affairs. But in non-democratic country, the parliament cannot pass a law about the army without the consent of the chief army, the dictator general of the army. Wherever it is run by the army, in that particular country, parliament cannot take any decision against the army or army head. So this is the very we can say bad element of non-democratic government, where there is no independency to the parliament that can take decision against the injustice going on there. But it cannot be happen in democratic country. Now once again, moving to the democratic side, any citizen can aspire to consent contest election for any post irrespective of his or her caste, religion, socio-economic and educational background, which means the right of vote is available to all citizens. In democratic country, consent is regarded of each and every individuals who are eligible to cast their vote. While you are casting your vote, you are giving your consent. Whomever you are willing to elect, you are allowed to elect those people. In democracy, caste, religion, social, economic, educational background are not mandatory. Above this, if you are the citizen of that particular country and you have been given the right to cast your vote. But non-democratic country, the citizen of the country have no right to vote. Here you don't have right, and you cannot take any decision regarding this. Once again, I am moving to the democratic side. तो डेमोक्रेसी इज बेस्ड ऑन द कंसल्टेशन एंड इन डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट पीपल एंजॉय देयर राइट ऑफ डिसीजन और डिस्कशन. मीन्स डेमोक्रेसी इज टोटली बेस्ड ऑन कंसल्टेशन. मीन्स नो वन कैन अलोन टेक डिसीजन. हेयर मेजोरिटी डिसीजन इज कंसेंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अंटिल अनलेस द कंसेंट ऑफ मेजोरिटी इज नॉट ग्रांटेड मीन्स नो डिसीजन कैन बी टेकन. बट इन नॉन डेमोक्रेटिक फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, नॉन डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट इज बेस्ड ऑन डिक्टेटरशिप. द रूलर्स डज नॉट वट ही विशेस. द रूलर डज वट ही विशेस एंड देर इज नो वैल्यू ऑफ द सिटीजन्स एस्पायरेशन. Where the aspirations of citizens are disvalued, and this is very bad element of the non-democratic that we don't have in democracy. So there are free and fair elections. Elections offer a choice and fair opportunity to the people to change the current ruler. Means in democracy, elections are held in a proper way, and there is transparency and fair election. There is no opportunity to change the current ruler without the proper legal procedure. In non-democratic form, in a democratic government, elections are either not held, and if held, they are not fair enough, rather they are imposing. Means while talking about non-democratic forms, you will most probably found that in non-democratic form, elections are held, but it is only for just formality. There is no chance of fair election, and even the peoples are not getting fair chance to cast their vote. The one more feature is there of democratic and non-democratic. So there is a freedom of expression, and people enjoy their fundamental right. Means in democracy, you have full-fledged right to express your opinion. Whatever you have inside and you are willing to express means you have the right to express your opinion. Even you have been given fundamental rights. The example, India. India is the largest democratic country of the world. But while talking about non-democratic, there is no freedom of expression and people do not enjoy their fundamental right. The non-democratic, you can give many examples like Saudi Arabia, Zimbabwe, etc. I hope you have understood the basic differences between democratic and non-democratic form of government. One more point we have. As you know, democracy have two more division, that is direct democracy and indirect democracy. So first of all, we will talk about direct democracy. As you know, it is a political setup where the people themselves make the law and parliament directly in the function of the government. Means in which country people are directly ruling, there is no one any middle step in between. This is called direct. The discussions are taken on the base of majority of the opinion, where the majority people decide that decision is taken up. It is suitable for the geographically small countries with less population, like ancient Greek, Rome, etc. Modern periods, Switzerland. So this direct democracy is only possible in less populated country of the world. Now, indirect democracy. In the modern world, most of the countries are falling in the direct democracy. The indirect democracy is only followed where the population is large, where all the population cannot sit together and take day-to-day decision. It is system in which the representatives are elected by the people. Because people cannot directly involve, so by their vote they are electing a representative who will rule the country on behalf of the people. So they are also sensitive to the cater the needs of the opinion of the people, like India, France, USA, these countries come under indirect democracy. I hope you have understood the topic up to here, and very soon I will come with the next video and keep the topic continue. So study properly, be safe. Thank you हैव अ नाइस डे।